Okay, I'm going to return to art talk specifically because, oh my gosh, I have this religious thing going on in my head so much I can't stand it, so I have to change the topic. I was going to talk a little about water, and then I'm like, no, it's gotten too heavy a topic of water, to explain it again and for the first time. So I don't really have a good clarity. So I'll just play show and tell to my teacher. I have a new teacher now. So I'm gonna tell him, show him what I did today in class. I have made a butterfly woman there. She's I make a lot of butterfly women, but yeah, she is there. And this is actually in response to the new artist I've seen, this Christopher Martin. And so those are my concentrics. They're a little different. Yeah. But so she's a little dancing fairy, and then she has, gosh dang it, I'm sorry, I have to change. I'm not, I have a new screen resolution today, so I'm a little larger. Watch out, she's getting bigger. And then what is this? Oh, there's another fairy there, and then this big in the background character. So yeah, I'm kind of excited with this one, but and then I have the two talking. The two talking, what are they? The two talking flowers. So yeah. So I'm working on them, and then I'm like, well, what was I really up to today? And yeah, I'm just trying to remove actually this discussion of the politics of religion. Of because it's got me into such a dilemma, I want to push everybody out here naked, and not just everybody, the whole, more and more, and just pile on here as many people naked as possible, and then yet they'll be screaming, it's just it's the worst thing ever for the for because they can't handle it, they're all too young, and they'll just use it as some kind of a new way to have sex. Rather than an actual, constructive event of nudity, where it's just a respected body place, it'll just be something that's just turned into, So yeah, it's kind of a bummer. It's kind of a bummer. And so what happens is it pushes us back into the religious rule. Yeah, well, the religious rule for sure. So I don't know. So I guess that's the deal, is we have to somehow increase the respectability of a person's body naked. But the thing is, there are so many people that aren't they don't keep their body temple beautiful. I mean, I myself get out of shape. So, quite often. And so it's like, well, if they're not keeping it beautiful, I don't know how we're ever gonna have a world of people that actually respect their bodies. You know what I mean? Their own body physical in the mirror. It's like, forget everything else. You're always looking for the health panacea pill. I think you're gonna have to, take off your clothes and look at yourself in the mirror first, and then learn that respect. And to learn that respect, sometimes it's just a lot of hard sweat and toil to even get to learning that respect, because you don't respect yourself when you're perhaps, too overweight. Yeah. So I don't know. I don't know. And then there's all this thing, the hiding behind. This they always say that the women get fat extra because they are hiding something. Yeah, some kind of weird thing like that. So they have all these old sayings that they do. But yeah, I don't know. So I got a little spasmodic, and I have to make it making these circles. But I can't really draw circles like that. Mine are more swirls. So it's interesting. It's interesting, isn't it? We all have our own way, huh? Oh my gosh. So this is kind of a useless video. useless one. I'm not solving anything, so I feel kind of in a predicament of a failure. Why do I have to solve everything today? I don't know. That's probably the rapidity in my heart, you know, I have to solve everything. It's just one of those moments, one of those moments when I didn't, you know. I look back, I just didn't. And I still remember, you know, I still have to, you know, and I'm like, why do I have to remember those little poor children on the borders or whatever? And you know, didn't you all, you know, watch that video? I pretty much instated the $50, you know, across the border. Isn't that going on? You know, I instated that, you know, many, many months ago. Yeah, I started fees there. So, yeah, how's that going? Anybody listen to me? So, yeah. You know, I offer the answer, and if you don't follow up with what I gave, I mean, who's to blame? Who's to blame? Yeah, so I get a little angry because I have a lot of answers that have been I don't know, neglected, rejected, forgotten. Pushed away. Yeah, so anyway. So what was I gonna say? Oh yeah, smile. Yeah, it's just a smile. Yeah, I know. I'm not promoting myself very well, am I? Yeah, I don't know. Talking little sunflower men, they're kind of cute. Kind of cute. I don't know. Sometimes I do I overcharacter, you know, maybe too many birds, and I start criticizing. Why'd I do that? Again, there's a reptile in there. This one, I don't know. It was difficult. I don't know where this theme is coming from, but I have butterfly and reptile and these talking flowers again. I don't know. Like I said, it's maybe something that just happens. Spontaneous? I guess so. I guess it could be spontaneous, or it could be stuck in a rut. Go ahead. It could be I'm just stuck in a rut. Flowers and what? Fairies? Flowers. Flowers and fairies. I'm stuck in a rut. I mean, like, you know, it goes into a point in my brain, and I'm just like, you know, only flowers, only fairies, only flowers, only fairies. Like a computer that hits a wall, you know, just turns around and hits the wall again, turns around. Yeah. Ugh. That's what wall is. Just duh. Mural. Oh my gosh, yeah. Milk. Whoa. Mon français, mon français. Oh, aujourd'hui. Oh. Non, plusieurs heures passées. Mais non, incroyable. Simplement anglais, retourné, we want a circle, no, we want a circle, un cercle, dans mon tête, I know, I'm lazy. What do you call that? There is a lazy word, périsir is lazy. Je suis parisien avec mon français. Yeah. And it makes me stutter and everything. So I don't know. This is weird, huh, to have the big video. Yeah. Feeling kind of funky. I have a new scarf. And it's a weird deal because the scarf is the same scarf that, what is it, that I purchased. It's the same quality, practically the same company that I purchased in France, and it's the same thinness, you know, the exact same thinness. So I'm kind of freaking out on it. I'm like, well, was my cousin there? And she bought it, you know, because it feels like their scarf, you know what I'm saying? You know, their orders. So it's a little bizarre. So yeah, that's not the greatest thing to actually be in witness of, because they have kind of cruddy quality there. So if this is becoming normal here, that's a drag, actually. I mean, I don't know. Yeah, it's a pretty thin scarf. So, anyway. Yeah, I hope that's not a normal. Oh, I had fun today. I'm working on yoga again. I know. This is a long video. I'm so excited to have a teacher. I can't believe it. I was like, oh, it's like I won the Price is Right. Yeah. Funny. I mean, did anybody ever see that Price is Right? That one. They played it over and over. That poor woman. She ran down there and her top flew off or something. She didn't care. And she was just bouncing away like a happy woman. She didn't care. Yeah, the bleepered one. That was like a big moment for America. The Price is Right woman fell out. Yeah, maybe there were several, but yeah, they did go on about that one aspect of the show. You know, that was like the greatest moment in TV history. Yeah, it wasn't Vanna White's dresses ever. Because after a while, they're all remembered as white, aren't they? They're remembered as white and marital, every single one of Vanna White's dresses. You know, I go back in like my mind space, in that history place. It's just like, yeah, she sold that one really well. It was like the marriage stairwell woman. Yeah. Yeah, never underestimate that, you know, the power of what do we call them, promotion, you know, just right there in her clothing. That's just amazing. Yeah. So, gosh dang it, there's a lot of traffic outside today, and yeah, I don't know. I guess they haven't changed the rule on that, what do we call it, that roundabout, moving them back to the highway, and yeah. You know, it's just simple. It's a very simple residential area. You block those ones, and then the ones that aren't, you know, you just put a sign up. Just put a sign up, and the ones that aren't, you know, when you start having like businesses, then you can drive on them. You know, it's just a pretty easy deal. There's no businesses along this thoroughfare. It's just a school. I guess there's a business that possibly a church or something, but yeah, just a school, I think. So yeah, they have to block it. Yeah, otherwise, I guess what happens is this becomes inner city extra, and we end up with increased crime, lower property value, and dun 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 dun. Just, yeah, let's just start chopping houses up and pulling the copper plumbing out, you know. So yeah, that gets kind of grody. I really would prefer that they could just start charging the motorists. So yeah. There's a Buddha in the garden, I guess. So she's always barking at it. There's this Buddha squirrel. It's a Buddha squirrel in the garden. Teases her. You know, I'm really nervous and tense up here. Yeah, my upper shoulders. I noticed, oh my gosh, this whole area. I don't know how to relax it. And when I'm going back to my body, myself, and the planet, in perpendicular format too, that my Arctic, what do you, my Antarctic, our extremities always get so cold under our head, and here's the Arctic. Down here is the Antarctic, and so and these are our toes. So we're like little miniature walking planets, just like Earth. We're just the exact little replica. We just happen to have the arms and legs. And some of us, some of us are a little rounder in the middle, to match the Earth. But when so this is Antarctica. My feet are Antarctica. And my head is the Arctic. And so in the middle, what do we have in the middle? We have all kinds of things there. We have the Mediterranean, we have the Caribbean, we have all those hurricanes going on, don't we? Yeah, a lot of hurricanes in the middle. There we are putting belts on all the time. And on our waists, all this friction spot. Am I looking thin? Am I looking fat? And we get a lot of friction in our waist area, and that's kind of funny. That's the same area that the hurricanes happen so often. Yeah, and then further on down south, we have Brazil and all of that, and that's where all of you're doing all of that extra, the bend over dancing, the doing the limbo, and is that what it's called, the limbo? There was the one where you walk on your, like, upside down, backwards in a back bend. Yeah, that one. And you don't really go for it, forward with your head. Ever. It's naturally done from the bottom portion of your feet. You take the bottom, you take Antarctica first, and then your knees, and then go through. So it's almost like the dance itself is in sync with the planet theory, of the body, of your body as the planet. So it actually is something that native tribes people did, naturally. So it's almost like they couldn't help it. Just had to be. Because we're not doing it up here. We're definitely not. If anything, we're doing the opposite. What we see with gymnastics, we do this launch back, Isn't that interesting? We always need to launch back. And that would mean, yeah, what does that mean? I don't know. We're headed towards Antarctica. No, not Antarctica. Oh my gosh, I'm sorry. I'm ditzing out the Arctic, where the Arctic, like Greenland area. Yeah, and so up there, we head up that way, and over there we go the other. So we have this big split in the middle, and what else is there? Oh my gosh, all kinds of things. And I'm like, okay, what does the belly button represent? Everybody wants to know everything exact, don't you? Where is that exact on the map? You tell me right now. I'm stressing out. Maybe I don't know exact on the map right now. Pushy people. There are so many pushy people that just want the answer. They want the answer of where. Good gosh. We're rotating. We're rotating all the time, unless we're dead. And well, I'm not a rotisserie item. We're rotating. We're moving. We're alive. And so that belly button, is a place on the planet, yeah. But I mean, I guess you could if you really want to be a local. I mean, you could say, I'm so local that that's it. That's my belly button spot. That's my center of the Earth, the universe. I mean, I don't know. I think that's kind of sick. I think that would be portrayed as a sickness. I don't think that's your locality, your belly button. I believe it's gonna be a place somewhere else on your body, maybe even a place that you manifest one of those diseases in. Yeah, because you've had a lot of people say negative things to you in it. So yeah, so we're like going, what? Yeah, no, I haven't been drinking. Yeah, I'm not an alcoholic, really. I'm not an alcoholic. I really enjoy it though, and I would love to be a wine taster, tester. I'm really good at the flavor deal, you know, knowing when it's this type or that. I've even written reviews, so I'm kind of an expert there. What is the other deal? Well, no, we're talking about trying to find our locality, and I already said it's the place possibly that manifests the most diseases on you. What else? What else? No, we're still not dealing with where the center is, because okay, we have I found the friction zone of the hurricanes. Sometimes I just wanna live there, you know, let's just live there in the friction zone of the hurricanes. I was gonna move there once to like New Orleans and be a singer in one of those pubs or bars or whatever. That was like a weirdo dream, daydream I had, you know, just go there and sing some kind of blues, you know, because my opera is just sucking and I'm just getting kicked out of coloratura, and I have to end up being some kind of a mezzo every day, and deeper into mezzo, so much so I might as well be in New Orleans. Yeah. So would I really enjoy it there? Probably not. They probably smoke, and it's probably just like all these expectations of jazz, and then you're gonna hear that thing all the time, that ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch, the sound that is like it's like a shake sound that goes, it hits on a drum, a shimmy sound, ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch- don't know. I'd have to hear that all the time, and then I'd have to, like, I don't know, just be really, really even more sad and more forlorn, and be like, just completely living in the past tense of the male species, getting older and older, and going, well, that was a day, and there was a fish, and blah blah, and, you know, I don't know. It just seems like such a gosh dang sad going on with it. So maybe I better not go that way. So what was the deal? Oh, there was another one. What show is that? And they say, what is the deal? I don't know. I'm thinking of Family Feud today also. I like that. I used to watch the Family Feud a lot with that cutesy dude with the sideburns. What was his name? I don't. I. Gosh dang it. Not Trebek. I did not watch Alex Trebek. Joker, Joker, Joker. Turn the table on it. Very. There. I didn't like the music. So I didn't really watch it. It was too hyped. So apologies to Alex Trebek. I didn't watch his show very often. Even when they had like the celebrities on, you know, when I thought, oh, they're extra stupid, you know, maybe I'll get something. No, I didn't really like the music, so I didn't watch the show. Was too bandstandy. So then back to the Family Feud, you know, that was just like I had to watch the Family Feud, you know, XXX, you know, there it is again and again and again, you know. And I'm like, what the heck? This incredible. It's an incredible show. No, really. Where do they get these people that they're showing up to even answer it? It's just another incredible that this is. And then I'm like, well, they're called Americans. And then I'm like, and that's the reason why people want to go to America, is to answer on these TV shows, maybe. Maybe that's the reason. Because I'm still not understanding why everybody says it's the greatest country on the face of the earth, of the planet. Now with this kind of traffic going by, and I've heard nothing in complaints about it. So perhaps that in itself is like, are you all guys okay? Are you all right? Do you need some assistance? Have you forgotten that there's traffic going up and down this street all day long unnecessarily? I mean, are you all right? Do you need help? Yeah. So we're losing our memories here. We're losing our mind. Our mind space is a Fukushima drifted in too far. Yeah, I'm not blaming Alzheimer's on anything anymore. I'm blaming this nuclear upheaval last, I don't know, what is it, 70 years. Yeah, on all of this brain forget. All right. So I won't try to dis in any of that ridiculous. No, I'm not trying to trade Oppenheimer funds up and down today. Yeah, I don't know why I get the feeling that that goes on also. Alrighty. So what is it? Yeah, more important of this video, I guess, was the learned lesson. You got Antarctica and you got the Arctic, and then you have all those other places in between. You're a little coochie-coochie there, so you're walking around on your own earth. In your own earth. On a earth. I'm not gonna give you the earth. But who is it? Leary probably would. Yeah, Leary probably would give you the earth and say, well, but while we're all bonded in, you can't get off of it. That's why gravity is like here. You know, gravity's still got you here. Gravity should get you off There's my road rage, everyone. Yeah. Gosh, dang it. What is the gosh, now my foot fell asleep. See, and then my feet do fall asleep often. It's almost like a reminder. You stupid. It's frozen freezing down there. You know it's frozen freezing. You have to move it. You have to move it. Just like you have to move the ice. Otherwise you freeze, you know. Yeah, you have to move those ice shelves. They have to fall, you know. They have to the cliffs have to fall and tumble into the ocean, and melt away and shift around, or you end up frozen, you know. So you see all these old people, and they're just walking around on their own frozen Antarcticas, and they're pushing. You know, they do that. They push those things, and they get, yeah. That's ridiculous. Like, I don't know. I'm not ever doing that. If I get that old, you know, like timeline wise, and I'm living, I guess what I'll do is I will have formally killed myself with apple seeds. That's my plan. Yeah, I'm gonna go the apple seed way. Yeah, I'm not being a walkie pusher type. I'm just gonna get it over with. So you don't have to worry about an old age folksy home for me. And that's not actually coming from the plunders of the sad broken heart of poverty. That's just really a for real. I just think the older we get, we become really crotchety and annoying. So annoying that we don't really have deservance any longer. I believe there were tribes that did take the old and just say, well, that's enough with you, pal. It's time for your walk. Just go. We'll throw a party. Throw a party for you, and you just take your walk out of here. And that's the way to do it. Just say that's the way it goes. And then they off and go, you know, to the desert. And that's a respect. It's a respect spot at the end of their life. They just take the walk out. They don't actually need a Burning Man trilogy. They don't need, what do you call that, Burning Man event. You know, they don't need that. They just need to just do it on their own, you know. You know, throw a party and let them take a walk. So, yeah, I don't know. Yeah, so that's the way it goes.